Look at the Hungarian method steps. So there are some steps, and the first step to solve the assignment problem, and I'm certainly considering the minimization assignment problem. The first step is to have the number of sources equal to number of destination. That means the assignment problem should be balanced. If it is unbalanced, then we can add a dummy row or a dummy column. I have already considered an example of dummy row and dummy column in my last video on assignment problem. In step 2, select the smallest element in each row and subtract it from each row as we did in the previous example. And in step 3, repeat this process for each column and subtract the least element of each column from all other entries appearing in the columns. The matrix that we receive after performing step 2 and 3 is what we call the reduced matrix. So that is the reduced matrix obtained from step 2 and 3. And here we start examining the row. So what we did in the last example also, start examining each row from the first row. If there is a unique zero in the row, then allocate it. So make a rectangle around it. Else move to the next row. Once all rows are covered, so we repeat this process for all rows. Once all rows are covered, then repeat this process for the columns. If there is a unique zero in the column, then allocate it. And then check the whole matrix as a whole. If each row and each column has a unique allocation, then it is optimal. If every row and every column got a square boxed, we have this as optimal solution. Otherwise, we move to the next step. And why this situation will appear, why we may not have an optimal solution, we'll be doing in a minute an example that addresses to this question. How do we proceed to the next case? How do we proceed to next case? And in step number 5, we draw the minimum number of horizontals and verticals line. Now, this is very important. We have to draw the minimum number of horizontal lines. So the first thing is either you do it randomly. I mean, you can try random lines. The line should be drawn to cover all zeros. So we have identified zeros in the previous step and we want to cover all those zeros. So either we can do it randomly, but ensuring that those lines are minimum in number. Okay, and or by following the procedure. So here is the procedure that we can follow. So we can look for the row which do not have any assigned zero. Assigned zero means which do not have the allocated zero which is assigned by the box. And then in that row, mark the column that have zero in the marked zeros, in the marked rows. And in the C, mark tick rows that have assigned zero in the marked column and repeat this process until this chain is complete. And then we follow the step number 6, which is about finding the least element of the reduced matrix not covered by any of these lines, and we subtract it to a corresponding element. So before I go to this step number 5 DE part, step 6 and 7, let me to take an example so these rules make more meaning. Now let's say this example and then I'll come back to the step number 5 to step number 7. Here is a problem which is based on a departmental head has 4 subordinates and 4 tasks to be performed. The subordinates differ in efficiency and the tasks differ in their intrinsic difficulty. His estimate of the time each man would take to perform each task is given in this matrix. Now he wanted to, of course, allocate one task to one person, so that is how we want to optimize. So allocate one task to one man so as to minimize total time. So as to minimize total time. And that is what is the assignment problem in this case. So let's start finding the solution of this problem. And we remember here the very first step that we did is the row minima. So I am just simply writing and we don't not need to go back here because this step was simple. Row minima was to select the least cost in each row and then subtract it in the corresponding row. So in the first row, least is 11. Well, subtract this 11 from all other elements, all other entries. So this makes it 7. 15, 6 and 0. In the next row, least is 13. So every time least will get changed, it will be selected from each row. So in the next second row, least is 13, so this makes it 0. So we have a quantity 0, 15, 1, 13. In the third row, the least is 15. So this makes 23, 4, 3, 0. And in the last row, the least is 10. So this makes it 9, 16, 14 and 0. And then we do the step number 2. And what is step number 2? Step number 2 is column minima. So now choose a minima in each column. And please note here, this column minima has to be done after the step number 1, not from the main matrix. So we'll move now from this matrix to this one. So what is the least in the column minima? Least in the column is a 0. So this first column will remain as it is. Whenever we have a 0 in that column, so that column will remain same. In this second column, the least is 4. So this means this will become 11, 11, 0, and we have a 12 here. In the third column, least is 1. So this will become 5, 0, 2, 13. And the last column will remain as it is because there is a 0, which is the least. Now, column minima is done, row minima is done. And this means after this stage, this I will consider as reduced matrix. So this is reduced matrix. After row and column minima step. After row, column minima step. Minima step. Okay. Now here I want to do the allocation. So either we do allocate here in this table itself, or we can make a next table also. So suppose I'll make a next table and then I will start. So this is reduced matrix. And we want to do allocation. So do allocation. So when I say do allocation, this means we want to make rectangles around the unique zeros in each row and each column. This is what we need to search. And zeros are the location which will correspond to the least time or the least cost, whatever has been asked in the question. Okay. So start looking from the first row. In the first row, there is a unique zero. Once there is a unique zero, in that column you see if there are any more zeros, cross off those zeros so that that uniqueness is maintained both side. Now we have two more zeros, so cross these zeros. So this means the A will be assigned to H person and H is assigned to A. So that is what? Both sided. Now look at in the second row. In second row, we have two zeros. So we don't know at this moment which can be assigned. Leave this for a moment. Move to the third row. In third row, we have a unique. So assign that. In that column, see if there are any more zeros. So cross off. If not, then we move to the next one. In fourth row, there is no zero now to be assigned because this is crossed off. And so rows are complete. Now look at column wise. So if I look at column wise, I have now this unique zero. Once I start allocating this zero in that column, this means E person is assigned to job B. So B job cannot be assigned to anything else. So once you do allocation in a column, cross that allocation, cross that zero in that row if appears. Okay. Every time we do an allocation in row, we have to cross off zeros in column. Or if we do an allocation in column, cross off the zeros in that particular row. Now, we see here that there are three allocations that we could have identified. And this last row has no allocation. This has no allocation. And third column has no allocation. Third column has no allocation. Now you may assign arbitrarily. You may assign this 13, obviously. You may assign this. But this does not guarantee that this is the least, this is going to give me the least time or this is going to be the optimal schedule. So possibly that we need to make these changes somewhere, probably this 0 to this 2, and then we can allocate to this 12 or any other possible combination. So we can't directly judge from here that which combination will give me the best optimal solution. So let's see here in my previous example that we have done. Let's see here. In this question, if you look at now in this question again, each row and each column have one allocation. So if we have this much number of allocation, what is the order of this matrix is 5 cross 5. So there are 5 allocations. And if we got 5 allocation at unique places where there is no overlapping between a particular job and a particular machine, this is optimal. So this is what it was, an optimal assignment time. Okay. But in this question, we did not. So let me hold this at this stage here, and we will go back to the steps of the Hungarian method and let's see this. So we are at step number 4. So in step number 4, we said after this, in the reduced matrix we obtained in step number 2, we have started allocating. We got these allocation. And if each row and each column has a unique allocation, then it is optimal. Otherwise, move to the next step. So this is not optimal. So we have to move to the next step. Now in the step number 5, in step number 5, I have to draw minimum number of horizontal and vertical lines to cover all zeros. So, and how do we do that? How do we select these minimum number of rows? So I have to put some tick mark to rows and columns. What are these? Let's see this again in the question. Okay, so this is a three-step process. So what I'm doing, look it carefully. Tick the row which do not have allocation. So this is my step number one. Tick the row, so that's the step number one. Tick the row that do not have any assigned zero or the allocation. Second step, it says in that mark tick column that have zero in the marked row. So marked row, that means in that tick row, tick the column that have a zero. In that row, tick the column that have zero. So once you tick that zero, because there is a zero, even if it is crossed off, in that column, tick the row which have assigned allocation. So this is a three-step process. I will repeat here. Let's see. Tick the row which do not have allocation. In that row, look where there are zeros. Tick the row which have a zero, even crossed off. In that column, tick the row which have only assigned allocation, that is boxed allocation, which is this. Now this three steps is complete, and now I want to draw the lines for marked. I want to draw these lines for marked column and unmarked row. So which are this? This way it is going to cover all zeros under the line. All zeros are going to cover under the line. And then we are going to make the next step. And then we move to the next step, that is step number 4 in my problem. And we'll find a new reduced matrix. New reduced matrix. And what is that new reduced matrix? In the new reduced matrix, now choose the least element among the remaining element which are not covered under the line. So the remaining element are 7, 11, 5, 9, 12 and 13. What is least? Least is 5. So choose least element not covered under line, not covered under lines in this case. So here it is 5. So this means now you subtract this 5 from all the entries which are not under the line. So this 7 become 2, 11 minus 5, this will become 6, and this quantity is 0. And 9, 12, 13 are also not under the line. So this means this will become 4, 7 and 8. Now write the elements which are under the line as it is. 0, 11, 0, 23, 0, 2 and 0. And then we have 0. I have left these two elements intentionally. Add this least element at the intersecting position of the lines. So you have to see which lines are at the intersecting position. These two are at the intersecting position. add the least element there. So what is this least element? 5 plus 13, this will become 18, and 0 plus this will become 5. So this is the last step, and from here we start repeating again the process. So let's see here in the Hungarian method. Find the smallest element of the reduced matrix not covered by any of the lines. Subtract this element from uncovered element and add the same to all elements lying at the intersection of any two lines. And for the remaining element, it was silent. So keep the remaining element in the same way. And now repeat the process. So we are again going to allocate. So now I'll allocate in this case also only. First row have 2 0. So this is not unique. Second row have 2 0. Again, it is not unique. But the third row have now unique 0. So this is allocated. And in that column, there are no zeros to be crossed off. Fourth row have unique 0. So I take this, and which means this is crossed off. This is fourth row. So the rows are finished. Start column wise. In the first column, I have now this allocation. This means this 0 is crossed. Second column already have an allocation. And third column, now this have the allocation. So each row and each column have an allocation. So we got optimal solution. So what is the optimal solution is? So optimal solution, I'm going to read it as, let's see, that A is assigned to task G. A is a task and it is assigned to men G. B task is assigned to E men. So this is my task. These are men. And C is assigned to F. So we read it directly from here. This is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. So we just read it. E is assigned to G and so on. And the last task, D, is assigned to H. And what is the total time required to do this job? Total time is, of course, that is the optimal value, optimal assignment value. And we know that once we say that this is assigned, this means here, the xij variable, these are the basic variables, and for basic variable this is 1, okay. And in this, of course, there are some degenerate basic variable for which the value is 0 also. Now, but in this case we only consider these allocations. So for these allocation, my total minimum value is simply adding the cost corresponding to these locations. So I need to simple add this 17. And then I need to add this 13, this 19, and then I have 10. So this will give me the optimal value. So we add 17 plus 13 plus 19 plus 10. So this is same Cij into Xij. But because Xij is 1, so it is only addition of Cij. And this quantity becomes 59 man hours. So that is the total time calculation. So this is the Hungarian method. And in the next video, I'll be covering some more examples to explain this Hungarian process to solve the assignment problem.